In the video today, we're answering a viewer question because Matthew S. asks us, why doesn't your tongue quickly stick to plastic or wood in freezing temperatures, but does stick to metal? First off, as you may have noticed, your tongue is coated with saliva. Shocker, I know, which is about 99.5% water. In order for your tongue not to freeze when sufficiently cold, the body sends blood rushing to the tongue in order to heat it up. However, metal in nearly all of its forms is a great conductor of heat, meaning that heat relatively freely transfers through it. If something conducts heat well, most of the time you can feel it, literally, which is why something like a metal wrench kept at 25 degrees Fahrenheit, that's -3 degrees Celsius, feels much colder to your skin than air at the same temperature. Of the common metals, copper and aluminium are the best at this. Some of the most expensive cookware is made out of copper due to its characteristic as a thermal conductor. As for aluminium, there is a reason tin or aluminium foil is a common household item and is often used in ovens. And if you're curious to learn more about aluminium, why not check out our video Why is Aluminium Foil Shiny on One Side but Not the Other for more on that. Anyway, while iron conducts heat at about 1/3 the rate of aluminium, it still does it really quite well. Stainless steel conducts heat at about 1/5 of the rate of iron, but is also often used in kitchenware as it's still relatively great at conducting heat. On the other hand, wood, plastic, and rubber are not good heat conductors, with wood being 150 times less conductive than stainless steel. This is why when you stir a boiling pot with a wooden spoon, you can hardly feel the heat in the handle. With a solid steel, aluminium, iron, or copper spoon, if you continued stirring like you would with the wooden spoon, you would quickly find yourself with a nice burn for your efforts. So, what really happens when you put your warm tongue on a cold flagpole? When the tongue makes contact with the pole, the heat is rapidly transferred, cooling the tongue and forcing the body to send warmth in the form of blood and heat energy. The problem is that today, most metal flagpoles are made of aluminium or steel, an iron alloy with carbon, making them fine heat conductors. The pole absorbs the heat quite readily, literally sucking the warmth from your tongue faster than your body can supply it. The saliva on your tongue then freezes, provided it is below freezing, with the resulting ice latching onto the flagpole and your very porous tongue. And essentially, with that, you are stuck. Materials that are less ideal conductors of heat won't provide this same rapid effect, nor even in many cases are they capable of cooling the surface of your tongue faster than your body can heat it to keep it above freezing. In some cases, the metal might even have an insulating effect. The more important question is, if found in this situation, how do you get unstuck? First off, do not pull or tug. If it is really cold and really stuck, there is a risk that a piece of your tongue could come right off, causing much pain and a lot of blood. Thankfully, there is a simple solution, and this is to just pour warm water over where the tongue meets the pole, warming your tongue, the pole, and of course, melting the ice. Of course, this is difficult to do without help when you're stuck to a pole. If by yourself, try breathing hot breaths onto the area. The moisture and warm air should dislodge the tongue. One could also try using warm hands and fingers to melt the ice. If none of these things work, call the local fire station. If you find it difficult to communicate your problem with your tongue stuck, the good news is that most emergency call centers these days accept text messages. Good luck. And now for a bonus fact. Some of the best solid heat conductors are actually diamonds. Diamonds can be up to 5 times better thermal conductors than copper. The strength of its covalence bonds create this characteristic, along with the strength in general of a diamond. Diamonds have long been considered one of the most unbreakable items in the world, though in truth they are often easily crushed to dust with a simple blow from a hammer. And now for another bonus fact. Licking an icicle can also cause a stuck tongue. While not as good of a heat conductor as aluminium or iron, it is about 10 times better than rubber at this. But as a general rule, if you stop licking things while you're outside, you'll be fine, and you should stop doing that anyway. So I really hope you found that video interesting. If you did, please do hit that thumbs up button below and don't forget to subscribe. We've got brand new videos just like this every day of the week. For more from me, why not check out my other channel called Highlight History. It's a sort of today in history thing that we are trying out. You can find that linked to below. And as always, thank you for watching.